Hey, it's Nas from Astronomy, and in this video, we'll go over how to take a poorly exposed image and turn it into something amazing. Today, we'll review the histogram and learn why it shouldn't be the main focus in your imaging session. This comes from a conversation I had with someone who's just starting astrophotography as a hobby, and he spends way too much time meddling with his exposure settings to try and get the perfect histogram, but after reading some things online that says the histogram must be at a certain point on your histogram in order to get the perfect exposure. The histogram is a tool that you should use as guidance, and it shouldn't be your main focus. As long as your data isn't clipped in either the very left or the very right side, the black and the white points, you should be able to get great results. And in today's video, I'll show you a good example of a really overexposed image that I took of the Crescent Nebula, NGC 6888, and I ended up getting great results anyway. I'll also talk briefly about flat images and where your flat images should be. So first, what is a histogram? So a histogram is just a graph that measures tones as a value on a bar chart. Now this looks like a curve, but it's actually little bars that represent the frequency or the strength of each tone represented by each of these colors here. There are several channels that you can look at, including color, luminosity, RGB, and the each individual color channels. The very left side represents the pure black, and the very right side represents the pure white. And everything in between are the shadows, midtones, and highlights. When I'm talking about data clipping, so this is one example of data being clipped to the pure black side. So this is not enough exposure. You can see that the data is here. Even if I try to stretch this, I'm not going to be able to get much. We can also look at the colors, and it's the same. So we're missing a lot of data. It's just gone. The camera does not have it. And the opposite is when you overexpose it. So if I look at the luminosity here, you'll see that the histogram is to the very far right. And I can guarantee you that a bunch of the tones in the image actually got clipped on this side, and it just does not exist. So even if I unstretch this, move the black point here, I won't get to see anything. So this is an example of a flat frame taken with my T5i. And I chose this example because you can see a really big dust speck of dust in the middle here. And what my flat frame does is it will, in processing, will take this and subtract the dust from every single one of my exposures. And the idea here, the exposure you should get for your flat frame is that it should be enough so that you can actually see the dust specks, but it should not be too much where everything just becomes pure white. And it shouldn't be too little where it just all becomes black. So if you look at the luminosity histogram here, everything is in the middle here. And this is pretty much where you want to be with the flat frames. But again, this should be the guidance. You don't need to be exactly in the middle. And to prove it to you, I'll actually edit the exposure, which you can do in Camera Raw. So you can look at the histogram here. And if I change the exposure, you can see that it goes more to the right. So this is probably at around like 70%. It was at 50% before. And you can see that the dust speck is still there. So if I use this as a flat frame, it would have worked. And if I had a lower exposure, if I had something like this, not too much, if I had something like this, it's more to the left, so it's a negative 10% reduction in exposure, I can still see the dust spot, and this would have worked as well. But if I were to make the exposure so high that it just all looks white, this would not work. Same if I go here, you can see that this is black, it'll just remove everything. I don't actually know how this would work, but the idea is to just get it to the center as possible, but again, don't stress it if it's a little bit to the right, a little bit to the left. You can actually go quite a bit and you can see the dust spot still. But for me, this is what I use for my flat frames. So this is an example out of a Canon DSLR. Right now, let's take a look at an astrophoto that I took here. And you can see that it is actually pretty overexposed. So this was a 240 second exposure of the Crescent Nebula. You can see that it's very white. The sky is kind of glowing. It was dark outside, but the sky was glowing. I took this with an L enhance filter just to try and get more of the H alpha. But you can see that in the histogram, the median is at 143. So it's not very significantly to the right, but it is right of the median. And normally when you read blog posts or whatever online, they'll tell you that the histogram for an astro image should be like around here, like one third of the way from the left. And that is good guidance. So that would be near perfect exposure for astrophotography. I'm telling you that you don't have to use that as like, hey, I have to make it over there during my sessions or I'll never get anything. So my data is not clipped here, and I can stretch this out to get more of the details of the sky, make it darker. And we can do that really quickly with camera raw filter once again. So I have this open, and one way to get the exposure down, as you can see, the ISO 1600, 240 second exposure. It's taken over a year ago, in 2022, and I can decrease the exposure, and you can see that I'm bringing the exposure down to like the third level or one third of the way from the very left. And then I can stretch this out to get more details. But this is just a single exposure out of 150 something that I got, I believe, and then stacked. So I won't spend time stretching this, and I'll show you what a stacked image looks like of the Crescent Nebula. So this is a single exposure, again, overexposed. I had hundreds of these and I stacked them together. And then this is what I got out of AstroPixel processor. This is completely unstretched. This is linear. And you can see it in the histogram here. So that's the luminosity. You can see the colors here. They're all pretty in line. And I can stretch this out in Photoshop or GIMP and make it look a lot nicer. Of course, I have a better version that I'll show you because I don't want to spend time processing this in this video. So I'll just do a really quick minute long curves and levels adjustments. So the first thing you'd want to do is do a levels adjustment. So if you do a Control L or you go to image adjustments and do levels, I can move the black point closer to here, move the white point down a little, and you can see the histogram starts to turn into bars instead of curves. So I can do this, and if you do Control M, you'll bring up curves. So I can do a little S curve here. You can see more of the data here. I'll do another levels. Again, this is quick and dirty. Do another curves. You can see the bars here. You can look at the histogram here. You want to make sure you don't start clipping data, so the left of this should not start touching the zero, which would be the black, the pure black. So press OK. And you can see that this is what it looks like once I start stretching the lights. If I do one more time, what would that look like? You can see it turns into bars. So this is not the best example, not the best work I've done, because again, it was just quick and dirty, but you can see so much more detail in the background. This is what the histogram now looks like. It's gotten stretched. And it all came from an overexposed light. And if you worry less about your histogram, you know, use it as a tool, as guidance, and not, you know, as the word of God or whatever, you can save yourself a lot of time, save yourself a lot of headache, and still come up with shots of deep space that you would be proud of. So this is just a quick and dirty stretch here, but if I were to take time with this, so this is what I actually came up with. So it says stars reduced. You can see the oxygen layers around the space brain here. You can see the nebula region on the left side. So this is like the Sator region. This is all in Cygnus. It's a beautiful region. This was done, you know, with an Allen Hans filter. So all the stars look blue because it was not captured in true color. I don't have any RGB shots of this. I think I need to redo this with my AstroCam anyway. But anyways, so this is the result out of this. Overexposed to really well processed. Don't want to toot my own horn, but if you think I could do better with this, let me know. I processed this like a year ago, never published this online, so I thought this would be a really good example to use here. So when it comes to the histogram, don't worry too much about it. Just use it as a tool, use it as guidance. So I hope this was helpful. This is pretty basic stuff with astrophotography. If you have any questions, ask. If you want me to cover something that I didn't, or you have any other questions about astrophotography in general, feel free to reach out to me. But until then, clear skies.